First Robotics was founded by Dean Kamen in 1989. He's an inventor and technologist, engineer. He and his partner Woody Flowers has brought the program up to extend to thousands of high schools around the world. The notion of it is first for inspiration and recognition of science and technology. And FRC is the first robotics competition. It's the highest level of the progression of programs within FIRST that starts with Junior Lego League, Lego League First Tech Challenge for middle school, and then FRC is the high school division. And there are several thousand teams competing each year. And the idea is that FIRST turns science and technology into a sport, just like any other at a high school, and brings with it all the excitement of competition, but also the experience and the growth and the education that comes from science and technology and the mentorship from working professionals. Build season is the most critical and the hardest part of FIRST Robotics competition. It starts on the first Saturday in January and extends into the third Tuesday of February. And it basically is a 6-week build period. From the date that we are launched, we get the game is revealed and the teams find out what it is their robot needs to do. It can be anything from shooting frisbees, to shooting basketballs, to stacking totes, to hanging inner tubes onto posts. And they compete against other high schools from around the world. And they have 6 weeks to design and build a machine, and then on that last day, called ship day or bag day, the robot goes into a giant plastic bag with a serial number tag on it, and a lockup form is completed, and the robot cannot be touched until the first day of whatever competition that team goes to. There are 5 weeks of competition, and teams usually register for one or two regional competitions. The only time that bag can be opened and the robot can be worked on is at a competition. So it's a really challenging experience for high school kids.
So the robotics team, it's just like a huge family or a huge community. Everyone's looking out for each other, and there's always someone to fill the needs of someone else if for some reason they aren't able to make it to a meeting. And we actually even eat meals together. Usually we have a meeting on Thursday, but now since it's build season and we have to get our robot done, we meet on Thursdays, Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays. So we're spending a lot of time together and bonding together, and so that's why we have these traditional meals. And usually during these meals, our team leader, Tommy, he always makes a speech to encourage us, motivate us, tell us what we might be doing wrong or something like that.
I just want to also remind you why you're doing this and talk about week three. Is kind of a representative of something that's going to, if you get it right, it's going to make you better and it's going to make you really effective for the rest of your life.
So I'm arms and lifts lead, which essentially means that I'm responsible for the majority of the construction of the robot, as well as solving any mechanical or design issues we come across. What we do is we design the robot on a computer before we really ever build anything, so we can solve any issues before they ever become a physical problem.
So my role in the team is I'm the public relations director, so PR for short. Basically that means that I talk to judges, I basically promote our team. So wherever we are, they need to know our team name, talk to judges, talk to other students, talk to our school, just get them to know who our team is, basically. So another thing that's really cool about our team is that we trade shirts. So this shirt right here is from Team 1011. They're from Arizona. Their team is called CRUSH, which stands for Creating Robots Under Severe Heat. And they wrote us a little note right over here, and then they signed it, which is all pretty cool. And something that we do is we trade the shirt back. So this is our jersey right here. And what we did for them is we signed it and, you know, wrote a little message as well. And that's something fun that we do.
So when I spin this one, I'm telling the program to automatically spin that one at a 1-to-1 ratio. So for every one revolution of this one, that one also spins.
Well, I joined the team my freshman year, and since freshman year, FRC has really helped me develop my skills as a future engineer. Like, since joining the team, I learned skills that I never would have anticipated. Like, in just 4 short years, I learned CAD, I learned how to use power tools, and I've gotten a large glimpse of, like, the engineering process that oversees the creation of a part from a mere idea to its final product as a tangible part.
So, what I've learned from FRC really is how to be a strong leader and how to help people do what they really need to do for the team. So, ultimately FRC is, it's building a robot, yeah, but it's a team building experience as well. Because it's all about working in program in a very small amount of time to do a very large task. So what I've done is I've taken on the role of the design manager, meaning that I'm in charge of integrating all of the CAD files. Now the CAD files are the 3D representations of the robot. So we build the CAD files before we actually do anything in the physical world, and this helps us to catch any problems that we might face when we're actually putting together the robot.
I've been seeing, oh, I've been seeing your soul. Give me things that I wanted to know. Tell me things that you've done. I've been feeling old, I've been feeling cold. You're the heat that I know. Listen, you are my son.